in Shortland Street.
I was just wondering, have you made a decision yet about Samoa?
Yes. We're going. I have to, for Dan's sake.
About Samoa?
How would you feel if I didn't come at all?
Don't tell me it's Monday already.
It's not Monday already.
You liar. Do you have to go on to work today?
You know, I have gone an entire weekend without once thinking of Shortland Street.
And it was bliss.
But I do have to show my face in there sometime.
Or do you?
Not a good look for the boss to pull a sickie.
Well, what if the boss just walked away from it all?
Meaning?
Well, the last year hasn't been a whole lot of fun for me. Having to watch you throw yourself into a relationship with someone else.
Everything's changed now, Robin.
Even so, I still think it would help everyone move on if we were somewhere else.
Like?
I want to move back to the UK. Make a fresh start and put all these bad memories behind us.
But we're just about to move into the family home.
Yep, which you shared with Sarah. I mean, hell, call it the hormones or something, but I just don't even know if I could stand that, Drew. So what do you say? England, here we come.
For you. What's this?
A man left it at reception. Said you'd know who it was from.
An ethnic gentleman. Any clues?
Saeed.
Grateful patient?
Yeah. Dan? No. He was the driver of a taxi I got into one night. I had quite a lot to drink, and when I got home, I invited him in.
Hi, you're just in time.
Thank you.
Guess you're not feeling too hot.
Well, goodbyes are always tough. I was a bit of a mess. But not Daniel. You know him, Mr. Hardman.
Yeah, but he's all talk. He'll miss you.
And Mum was bawling the whole time, making this huge scene. And then Dan goes through the departure gate, and she's like, you took our boy away, and now you're packing him off to the islands? What kind of mother are you?
Hey, I'm really sorry about what I said last week, about you being clingy.
No, thank you.
I bet he'll miss you, and in a couple of months he'll come running back. I remember sitting at boarding school wanting nothing more but to be with my big brother. And now look at us. Haven't heard a word from him since he hooked up with that nut bar. Not that I'd want to.
Yeah, I am going to have to find my own place.
No, as long as you're here, then he won't move that nut bar in.
It's his house.
Half of it.
Look, I don't belong here, Claire. You know it's got to be this way.
So he's your... You're his... Have you seen this man?
When I woke the next morning, I had a terrible hangover. Then I got a shock to find him in my bed.
You didn't sleep with him?
So I was awful to him. I screamed at him to get... I mean, poor man must have thought he was dealing with a psychotic. My rock bottom, I think.
Taxi driver.
More coffee.
What does the note say?
Have a read.
I have nothing but good thoughts about the time I spent with you, and I hope you remember the words I taught you.
Fat chance. I'd drunk so much I could barely remember where I'd been the night before.
Judy. I hope I can see you again, and I enclose my home phone number.
10 points for trying, Mr. Taxi Driver.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're not going to use the phone number.
Well, I hadn't thought about it, but if I was, what would be so wrong with that?
He's a taxi driver. He's foreign. He could be a terrorist.
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
You don't know the first thing about him.
I know he's the only person who's bothered to show any interest in me in a very long time.
It's not true.
I know what people around here think of me. The battle axe with no life of her own. The pitiful spinster who spends every night at home alone with only her dog for company.
Judy, no one thinks
of you. Well, I've got feelings and I have a life.
And sometimes I behave really badly because that's exactly who I am. So you can all go to hell.
There's something dodgy about him.
So you've said 1,000 times. My gut feeling is his intentions are good.
Right, so I guess it comes down to a choice between your instincts and mine.
Would it make you feel better if we got Garth to do a background check on him? We'll get his CV, personnel files, references, take a look at them.
So you do have reservations?
No, I'm trying to put your mind at rest.
Well, I doubt the CV's going to do that. His behaviour with Amanda is professionally inappropriate. What we need to find out is why the clinic got rid of him.
Don't worry. Garth will be very thorough.
Would you like me to call room service and get you anything else?
No. But I do want an answer on England.
Ah, it's not that simple. I've got Claire to think about.
But you've also got a brand new family now. You can't put Claire before that.
She's still so young. Maybe when she moves out and I'm free of work commitments, we can move. But right now, it's impossible.
But I've been through so much and I've waited so long to have you to myself. I just don't want to share you.
You have got me. We've got each other. So don't go doing anything silly.
Whatever I've done in the past was only because of losing Caleb. I was lost. And I was desperate to make you see how much we needed each other.
Yeah, it was a rough time for all of us. But you have to trust me on this one. I can have both you and Claire in my life. I shouldn't have to choose.
Okay.
And don't feel funny about the home. Sarah and I might have lived there together, but she and I were never a proper family. Not like you and I are going to be.
Mr. Elia needs a prescription for diclofenac.
There's an R40 coming in. Get someone else to do it.
It'll take 5 seconds.
Motorbike versus powerball at high speed. Fractured tip and fib. GCS 14, pulse 78, and BP 90 over 60. Okay. On my count. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, Blake. Seems to have a bit of trouble there, mate.
Mark Weston.
Yeah, he's hypertensive. He must be bleeding from somewhere.
Right.
Now where you are, mate?
Hospital Weston. I may be looking shabby, but I could still whip your ass in the squash courts any time.
I don't doubt it. Now, can you tell me exactly where it hurts?
Back and shoulders.
I feel a slight prick. I want to bite myself. What are you riding?
I just got a new...
Sorry about that, mate. Edmund Soft. Can you feel me doing this?
All I can feel is this bloody needle.
Let's see her in here quick.